I literally don't know anything. This is going to be a party.
This is.
I'm going in blind and hard.
Hard and blind. Welcome to Oh Yeah Big Time. This episode is not brought to you by NFTs. Remember NFTs? All right. So that's, yeah.
Oh, usually it's longer.
Well, you know.
That was the joke, is that it was brief.
Just as NFTs were short-lived.
So is the intro.
So is the ad from NFTs.
How long would you say the NFT Finanzaganzo
the NFT Finanzaganzo lasted probably
like 3 months.
I think the peak of it was 3 months, and that's when it died. Was after that.
What happened?
If it takes 5 attempts to explain something to somebody,
yeah, I wouldn't even say 5. It takes. I still don't know.
It's kind of like when you have a company. And you practice your elevator pitch.
Yeah.
Because you need to say succinctly what you do, who it's for, what the problem it solves, and why it's great.
Yes.
You can't do that with NFTs. You can't.
All I know is, why can't I screenshot the picture and just have the picture for myself?
You can.
They're like, but you own it. And it's like, who fucking cares if I own it? Like, what the registry knows. It's like, okay, well, I have the picture as my profile picture. I stole it. What are you going to do about it?
What are you going to do?
This is my Slack picture.
No, an NFT is a digital certificate that that certifies ownership of digital goods like art or weird art or weirder art.
I'm not into like any, I'm not. Technologically, I don't get into any of it, but I am proud I didn't get into that one.
Yeah.
Because I knew.
I think we all did.
I don't know. Some people got really
well,
into
there
it.
Were the
I
NFT boys. The people who got into NFTs were the people who were late on crypto and wished that they weren't.
Right.
And so they're like, this is the
this
new
is
crypto.
The thing. And it's like, no.
I can't miss out on
they're
this.
They're spending thousands of dollars.
On a picture of a bunny.
Or a GIF or like... limited edition penguins with outfits. Plus, with like Midjourney, you could really make some NFT.
I think
NFT cheese.
That was also all these artists came out of the woodwork and they're like, "I'm going to make NFTs," yeah. And that coincided right with the AI art boom.
That's true. Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I thought I was off speaker, so it would divert into the walls. We're gonna have a great time.
But yeah, Midjourney can make an infinite variation of any NFT category or series.
Do you ever go on Midjourney, or is that just me?
I don't, but I'd like to, but I don't.
It's like
that's another one that's like you have to go into a Discord server, yeah. And you have to chat, and everyone can see what you're generating.
And so many people, because you're supposed to do slash imagine, and then your query. But people just type the query and then they start freaking out. They're like, why isn't this working? And then I start a thread and I'm like, you have to type. And they're like, thank you so much. I'm like a really nice person in there.
What a weird world.
It's a weird time in there. Like, it's very revealing. And then I'll judge people. I'm like, they've been in here for like 2 hours fine tuning this picture of this girl. And then I'm like, I really want this potato soda to look real. So I'm just going to keep doing this for 2 more hours. So who's better really? But...
potato soda.
Brought to you by potato soda. I love Midjourney. I don't know.
But yeah, with NFTs, there was that monkey.
What?
You know the monkey?
No.
Google search NFT monkey.
NFT monkey. What is this?
Yeah, that's the monkey.
I have no idea what that is.
So there was like a whole series this guy made of these monkeys.
The
and they were
ape?
Selling for... Yeah, the bored ape, sorry.
Are bored apes a good investment? How
much
did they cost?
No, it's not, because Midjourney could spit out 4,000 variations of that. And I swear, that's just...
$2.7 million?
Yeah.
No shit. Oh, man.
And that's just one of the gorillas from the band. I swear, that cartoon band.
Huh. Okay, so when I was like, sell for thousands of dollars, I didn't know they were selling for millions of dollars.
Millions of dollars.
What was the most expensive NFT sold? $92 million.
What was the picture of? Oh, the pixel. Yeah, the pixel guy.
This is like the most first world, like just bomb us. Just get rid of it. You know what I mean? If you have like $92 million to spend on this, you can't be here anymore.
Well, I also think what finally did NFTs in was the NPC TikTokers.
Oh.
Like,
why?
I think when the NFT bros saw the NPC TikTokers, that's when it hit them like, oh, that's us. Like, this is just a weird trend.
Okay.
A weird fad.
So is NPC people done?
No, that's still going on.
Oh,
but okay. We give that 3 more months. Then well, it's then gone
forever.
We should
forever. Get in on it quickly because that's a pretty easy. We need 1,000 followers so we can
that's
be
true.
Extremely late to the NPC.
We can
but
do
you're
it.
You're like a great meme mime guy.
Yeah. Thanks for the roses. Thanks for the roses.
Lasso.
Oh, no. Oh, no. That's be, all it is.
It's a great. 1,000 followers. Let's do it. I think you'd be a great NPC, and I don't mean that in a mean way. Just
well, thank you. I can like mime.
You're a great mime.
So, yeah. I mean, one day, like, we don't need to prove that we own any digital asset. No one needs proof of that. You have how many files on your computer?
Hundreds of thousands.
Do you need proof that you own any of them?
No. Like, we're shitting on gold. How about an NFT? Like, well, I have $2 million. Okay. Like, that makes the gold people look like geniuses.
I mean, props to the artist. Because they made a lot of money.
Oh, yeah. I'm
shame on the buyers. Shame on you.
Well, they were supporting art.
But so like also an art, in a
like
stupid
someone
way.
Someone makes this like shitty pixelated thing and they're like retired for life.
Done,
although
yeah.
They probably like blew it all very quickly.
Sure. Lambos.
Lambos, the type of person that makes. And there's nothing wrong with the art, but the person that made that art is not investing in gold and in their future.
No.
No.
They are not. Speaking of gold, we got in trouble.
We got in trouble.
Oh.
I don't know if I'm ready to talk about this.
We got in trouble with the gold boys.
We didn't know the Goldbergs.
Goldbergs.
I didn't know that was a thing.
I had no idea.
And now that we've like gone, because, well, should we tell the people?
Sure. So last week on the podcast, we talked.
It was two weeks ago, which is why it's weirder.
Two podcasts ago, we talked about gold. And we don't know what we're talking about. We don't know. We had no idea what we were getting into.
This is a comedy podcast, or trying to be a podcast.
We're just saying stuff.
We don't matter. We're just talking about gold.
So we're talking about gold, and we say how in the apocalypse, gold is worthless.
And
as worthless
is.
As the U.S.
dollar. I stand by that 1,000,000,000,000%.
Absolutely. I mean, Warren Buffett, Mark Cuban... there was another one.
A really important one.
Dave Ramsey.
Yes.
They all think gold is bogus.
Which I usually don't align myself with the billionaires, but in this instance, I'm like, well, I'm all with capitalists. They know what's up.
Well, I mean, they know what they're talking about.
They know what they're talking about.
But more than like some guy in Kansas.
I screen recorded the comments, but I was also very anxious, so I scrolled very quickly. May I see if I can discern any of
them? Well, here's what. So we posted this to TikTok, and on TikTok, the video was fine. Like, a few people were like, you're stupid. But that was it. On Instagram, however, the Goldbergs came out of the woodworks.
My God.
And it kind of, like, it was getting insane. On this Instagram reel that we posted.
And it's like a dumb video. We're not even criticizing
gold. Obviously, gold has value.
Right, and they're like, you don't know gold does anything. I'm like, no, it doesn't do anything in the apocalypse.
Like, that's what we're, like, gold has value now.
Right.
It's worth something. It's worth it's dollars.
Like, they're like, you fucking idiots, because we're like, a bar of gold is $194,000. And they're like, oh, if only there was a way to make that into coin. Like, I know there's coins. What we're saying is if you were the master of gold... If you were the top gold guy, you couldn't do shit with your $200,000 bar.
Right. And even then, we were looking at gold coins.
They're expensive. One ounce was like $2,000.
One coin is like $2,000, $10,000.
So they have the gold bucks.
Then there's gold backs.
Backs.
There's gold backs.
Which is like gold scam times 1,000.
Someone is making
printed fake Monopoly money.
It is unbelievable.
That alleges to have one thousandth of a troy ounce of gold.
But if
on the buck,
put it in your wallet or a like the gold is gone. We should start one.
We should just start printing gold backs.
Yeah, with construction paper.
Goldbergs gold backs.
And there's like, so they have that, which literally no, that's just a Ponzi scheme.
Yes.
1,000,000,000%.
And then, a company is just making that.
Right.
Which, that's not real.
Kudos to them. I actually applaud them.
Like, you're going to take a gold back to what? Wendy's?
Yeah. Here.
You're going to take a, where are you going to take a gold back? To the car dealership? I'd like to buy a car. I have $40,000 in gold backs.
And it could be 40. They put $40,000. It does not matter.
Sure. The car dealership's going to say, that's fine, but we need money.
Like, they would take your gold before they would take the gold bucks.
And in the apocalypse, you're going to go up to somebody and be like, I need a horse. My horse just got shot and died. I need a new horse. I have $10,000 in gold backs.
I have a stack of them with a rubber band.
And they're going to say, okay.
What the fuck is this?
And then you're going to get shot in the head.
Because it's not a set currency. So there's like different bulk goods makers, right?
Yeah.
So it's like there's no standard. So it's like, this one says it's 10, this one says it's 100, there's no...
And maybe we're uneducated.
Maybe we're uneducated, maybe we're stupid.
We're not criticizing gold as an investment now, although it could be criticized.
Yes.
But what we are criticizing is gold as some sort of apocalyptic safety net.
And they acted like it was so stupid when we're like the prospector. They're like, of course you can... test the purity.
You can test the purity of gold using mercury. I learned it in 7th grade. Like, okay, what school did you go to? Prospector school? Sorry, I'll stop doing that. But
then I'm like looking at this because I went and down, but there's like gold bars that's like thick of gold.
Thick of gold.
Cut in and it's tungsten. So it's like how many people have in their fucking bunkers is that how you say tungsten?
I think so.
Tungsten? So it's like they think they have gold because it's the same weight and shit, so they think they have gold. Like, they think they're all superior. You have tungsten.
If you're investing in gold just to, like, try to make money, that's fine. It's like
gold,
it's like
an IRA, no
it's like
problem.
Buying a rare Pokemon card.
Yeah.
And trying to resell it later when it's worth more.
Yeah.
Fine. But it's not going to get you through the end of days. It's just not.
My fear when you're like the gold people talk to us, I thought it was going to be those investor types because I think there is a use case for the gold, right? So I'm sure. Like, oh man, I don't want to get into... No, it's just the people that buy gold coins that are after us.
It's the people who are scared.
They're very scared.
The people
scared.
Who are scared
they're
are
so
also
scared.
Scary.
And they are so angry that we're not scared because
yes.
They have this...
History repeats itself! That's what they say. They like to say
over
that.
Over and over. And they're like, if you look to Venezuela, and they're like, it's so crazy to me how angry they get.
But they got real mad at us.
They got so mad.
It became such a poison post thread that we just had to delete it.
Well, we were in okay territory for a minute.
Right. And then
and
you
then
insulted.
I snapped.
You insulted someone.
Multiple people. And then you, because you were kind, you're like talking back, but like. Kind of, you know.
Sure.
But then I get, and I can't repeat it on the podcast, but I lash out a little bit.
You did lash out, and that's when we had to.
Yeah, because you saw on the preview, like you saw the comment notification.
Yeah.
And you're like, no.
It's like, we have to delete this.
I deleted my Instagram because they're like really scary.
Oh, they were threatening.
Yeah, like not in a jokey way. Like I'm off Instagram because I'm like these.
Well,
I fucked with the wrong
it
people.
We don't want to be a poison angry. Like, sure, we'll get like jovially mad about something.
I just thought it was funny.
But we're not like we don't care about anything.
We don't care about anything. And they're mad that we don't care because their investment is not paying dividends.
It invalidates their anger.
So it's like if the world's not ending, I have this stash of gold and I can't afford anything else because I have my gold pile.
I can't think of one like idea. That I would truly defend with any sort of fervor.
Vigor?
Yeah.
Yeah. Like...
Nothing.
I'm trying to think. I have, like, issues I get triggered by, right? There's, like, certain political... But even then, if I see something on Instagram, I'm like, yeah, that's the other side. All we did was say, if there's an apocalypse, don't need gold. And they're like, what the fuck did you?
How dare you?
Yeah.
It's like, what do you, I mean, just get over it. Just have your, if you like gold, fine. Keep your gold.
Yeah, we're not trying to take your gold away. No,
we're literally not doing anything to your gold. We're just saying, I think it's worthless.
Like.
And they get so mad. But we learned from watching like Warren Buffett and Mark Cuban, we learned that like we're not alone.
Goldbergs.
If you criticize gold,
yes,
they will attack. They will find you. And Instagram knows that.
Yes.
So they were like, oh, someone's criticizing gold. Let's send it out to the Goldbergs.
Because that's the only way they just match whoever's passionate for and against. So there's probably anti-gold people, but they know not to talk to the Goldbergs.
Yeah.
Like
they know, we did not know.
We didn't know.
We just posted, like, oh, this is a funny take on gold.
But what a
And so we posted it on TikTok. Fine. Everything was fine. Then we posted it on Instagram and we were
scared for our lives. The irony is like they're so scared, but they also want the scary thing to happen. I truly think they want it to happen.
They do. They really want it to happen. Like for the October 4th thing. Are you familiar with this?
Vaguely.
So on October 4th,
the world is ending.
FEMA is going to send out an alert to all the phones. And it's going to sound like this. Bam! Bam!
This is a test. This is a test from the, you don't need to do anything. Which they've already done. They do these.
They've done this.
Like, it's not a new thing.
Like, Obama did this, right? Like, 10 years ago.
They do it regularly on the radio all the time.
Well, on the radio. Yes, exactly. But they did this on TV. Like, my dad would be in the middle of watching, like, Gunsmoke. And he'd get interrupted with, this is a test of the emergency. And, like, nobody cared. No one was scared.
Yeah, like, my program was interrupted.
But nobody watches TV anymore.
Yeah.
TV isn't real. So they have to test it on the thing that we use, which is our phones. There's nothing sinister behind this, but people are really scared.
It's so, like, get off your... If you're scared of 5G and you're scared of October, fine. Get off your phone and get off TikTok. Otherwise, I don't want to hear it. If you're using a 5G device and talking about how you're getting poisoned and... shut up.
Like, and also, we want that to work.
Right. That's...
So we want them to... As, like, we're involved in, like, tech, so we know... Software is tested. Functionality of things is tested.
It's good to prove that it works.
So you want to know it works before you have to find out in real life.
The rough way. Because didn't they do in Hawaii, like their whole system didn't work?
I don't know. I don't know if that was intentional or not. But
still, it's like we want to know if...
We want to know. But there is a whole crowd. It's probably the same. There's got to be some crossover.
There's gold overlap.
The people who love gold... And will attack and threaten other people for criticizing gold are got to be largely the same people who are worried about October 4th and the sound that their phone will make.
Not worried, all angry. They're trying to stop it.
They're
trying to get it stopped. Israel might get it stopped, but we're going to try, but we probably won't be able to. It's like, what do you want to stop?
People are saying, like, the frequency that we'll play. The frequency that will play on your phone is the loudest sound ever recorded. That's what they say.
Really?
They say it's the loudest sound to ever be recorded.
Wow.
It's like there are physical limitations for the speaker on your phone.
Right. That's why each time they release a model, it's like you can hear your music because it's...
We've improved the speaker system. Like, this sound isn't going to, like, somehow transcend the physical limitations of the hardware of your phone.
Maybe Timmy Cook, maybe 100% on the phone is actually 10%. Maybe it's built in. And there's a conspiracy with Android and Apple that they're reserving this sound.
Right. There's a threshold that they've limited on these speakers. And somehow it's going to be like a sonic blast.
At worst, it's the loudest sound you've ever heard. Then what?
But they're worried about the frequency. There's a theory that the frequency is going to disrupt the brain and cause people to freak out and attack each other. Or
like what they're doing already. They
activate
don't need
the 5G chips from the vaccines that you've been implanted with.
Is that what you were watching the other day? Where they're like the nanoparticles are going to be activated by the radio waves?
By the frequency.
What is the science behind that?
We can go ahead and do an experiment on this right now. Do you have the notes pulled up?
Yes.
Okay. So this is every frequency that you could possibly hear.
Is this going to shatter my eardrum?
I hope not. We'll see.
That would be hilarious. Ready?
Yeah.
Wait, what is this?
This is every frequency that the human could possibly hear. This is every frequency that your phone can play that you can hear.
Our brains just explode as this video plays.
So this is a very low frequency. Can barely hear it.
It's kind of soothing. That actually feels really intense.
So it wasn't pleasant.
It wasn't pleasant. But also, they're not going to do that pit. It's just going to be like, meh.
But if it's any of those frequencies, which it has to be, because if you hear it, it has to be something that fell in that window.
Yes.
So if it's one of those frequencies that we heard along the way.
Along with the hardware limitations.
And we didn't die.
Yeah.
We didn't attack each other.
Unless they're hiding what frequencies we can hear.
And also, they're saying it's the loudest sound ever recorded. What happened to the people who fucking recorded the sound?
Well, that's part of the conspiracy.
They just had to have a line of like audio technicians ready to take over when one died.
And then
it's completely impractical.
They're buried underneath the sound chambers.
Yeah.
Like, there's all that. And also, turn off your phone.
Or don't. Just be a normal person who's not afraid of a sound.
But if you're scared, turn off your phone. Take a nap.
And also, people are legitimately scared that this is going to turn people into zombies.
Like,
yes.
Like flesh-eating
zombies. So people are referencing Stephen King's movie Cell from 2016, which I had no idea even happened.
What is going on with these like pop culture like Someone wrote a book, so they were prophets of the future.
No, they think that the powers that be are implanting these messages into pop culture.
As to what? Subliminally give us clues?
To tell us.
To tell us.
So they can say, we said it.
Why would Stephen King's tip us off?
Cell from 2016, which nobody knew existed. How about that for a Mandela effect?
Yeah.
That movie was never made.
Never made. Like, why would they ever want to tip us off?
We have a clip from that movie in the notes. If you want to pull that up, I just wanted to see, because people are saying, like, Stephen King's Cell predicted this. We know what's going to happen when this sound goes off. It's already been warned. But yeah, this is Stephen King's Cell. This is the scene that everyone's referencing, the people who are scared of this sound on October 4th. They're scared that this is going to happen.
This movie never existed.
No.
With John Cusack?
John Cusack, yeah.
All right, here we go. Sorry.
So there's a sound playing.
Which seems to be affecting everyone at different times.
Yeah. People are vomiting. People are falling over. Yeah, my favorite scenes. Yeah, she's throwing up. Oh, my favorite scene's coming up. I'm so excited, yeah.
What is he?
I don't know why he's not affected. He's carrying. This guy's just vomiting on the shitter.
Is he immune to the sound?
Like somehow.
People just. How is this not a comedy?
He's just punching this girl. So, yeah, so.
So that was the first.
They're worried that this is going to happen in real life.
Well, did John Cusack do that to him?
No, that was another person.
Oh, they're about to become alive.
This guy warns and then just runs away.
She's calling 911. Just sleep.
This is my favorite scene right here. The police officer is eating the dog. So, yeah, that's John Cusack.
That was riveting.
In Cell from Stephen King.
So the hires that be are tipping us off through Stephen King to let us know
that one, that this is going to happen. Also, if they're going to do this,
why plan it?
Why are they telling us when they're going to make us all zombies?
Like, if they want to do it, just fucking do it when we can't turn off our phones and we all have it happen.
If this was going to be like the end of the world.
Right.
They wouldn't tell us, and they would just press the button.
And then our heads would explode, and we'd start eating our dogs.
Yeah.
What? Man, there's so much to, like, deconstruct here. What is the incentive of the government having us, well, one, become zombies?
Do you want me to actually tell you?
Well, yeah, yes, of course.
It's the Great Reset. Have you heard of the Great Reset?
No.
The Great Reset... when they wipe out civilization.
Who? The Illuminati?
The Illuminati, kind of okay. The powers that be, want to start from scratch.
Like the world or like?
The world.
Because it's not the continue.
Well, there's this spreads off into fractals of conspiracy theories.
Like Christianity has a bunch of branches.
Yes.
Yeah.
And a certain segment of people believe that there's an ice wall. And this is largely flat, probably only flat earthers.
Where's the wall?
They believe that there's an ice wall that surrounds the earth.
So it is flat, yet there is unmelting ice.
The earth is much larger than we think it is.
Why does that have to be part of flat earth?
Because this literally can't be true unless the earth is flat.
But it also can't be true if the world's small, the current size.
Well... So they think that there's an ice wall that surrounds the earth. So yeah, so I just sent you a link to this ice wall. Now, this is sort of what they think has happened.
Okay.
But beyond that ice wall is another plane of land that continues with continents that have yet to be discovered.
So that's a really bad diagram.
Well, I found it on my phone.
I'm not saying you did. I'm saying because whoever built this is part of the conspiracy and they've done a bad job.
Well, that's why there's sort of sectors, if you will. So I'm going to send this to you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is what they think Antarctica is that initial wall is Antarctica.
Is this, can you see my cursor?
Yes.
Is this Antarctica?
So, yes, they allege that first inside ring is Antarctica.
Okay.
And that is separating us from the true world. And that we are merely living in a playpen of a work factory.
What?
That makes their world all happen.
Like we're like the generator and silo.
Yes, exactly. And so
I don't even have questions because.
Yeah. That, I mean, they think that. So
the moving island. Thoth is the one moving island. Is anything. But it's still flat. All of this is flat.
Oh, and also each ring. So like the inner area, our area has a sun and a moon.
Yes.
That spin around. But also the outer ring outside of our circle. Has its own sun and moon. And then outside of that is another sun and moon.
Oh, I see three.
So there are three pairs.
I think there's four. Is the yellow the sun?
Oh, there's old moons.
So there's four. God, this is like wrecking my brain. Also, like, why don't any of them have names outside on the outer... So, like, is the...
Well, we don't know what they are because we're trapped in our little
playpen.
Well,
how do we know what the one is outside of us?
We don't. This is all made up.
Is the middle the playpen of the outer? Is the outer controlling all of us?
I think so.
Do they see what happens in the Arctic and the glaciers? Like, how thick is this ice?
Well, it's an ice wall, and it
but
is.
How thick
it's
is
as
this
tall
ice wall?
As the Eiffel Tower.
That's
and,
not that
And they
tall.
Allege that there are people, that there are military stationed around the ice wall that prevent you from getting to the ice wall.
Are there any
to climb
photos
the ice wall.
Or purported?
Yeah, people have been over the ice wall. They just don't want to acknowledge that.
What? Sorry, just quick sidetrack. Can you remind me how space works?
There's no space.
But what is...
In the flat Earth world, there's no space.
Everything is photoshopped that comes back from NASA.
Yes, everything from NASA is photoshopped and fake.
But what do we see?
So what we see are lights in the firmament. The firmament is a wall of water or a dome of water that covers
around the sun,
the planet, the Earth. Yes, the sun and the moon are inside of the firmament, according to flat earthers.
Okay.
So they think that there is a ball of shine that is very bright.
Very
bright. But when it's on the other side of the flat disc, we can't see it.
Right. I'm getting a little angry, so please keep going.
I'm just saying that these are the people...
Wait, so the reset, the great reset is when the outer rim
The outside rim
us.
People want to reset us.
So does our government have ties to the outside?
Yes, it is ultimately informed and directed by the outside.
So it is like Silo, how they have the...
Yeah, the tiers.
So is this a sacrificial kamikaze? The government's going down with this, or do they have like a bunker for the reset? What happens
They haven't thought this through.
This is so aggravating.
They just have these fantastical
but they have to think
imaginations.
It through if they're going to try to be making these claims.
Well, some of them probably have. I'm just going through the internet and I see this and I'm like, wow.
Wow.
All right.
Like, and I'm not like the government is pure and they would never, but it's like, you're going to have to really sell me on the concept of why they would want to kill the taxpayers who fund them on their little excursions and give them power.
Maybe we're getting ready for another mud flood.
Take me with you, mud flood. I'm sick of it. I can't take it anymore. Happis, batwapa, badira.
But there is great crossover between the Goldbergs.
Oh, yeah.
The October 4th fears.
And this.
And the flat earth. Outside ring, sun, moon, inside globe thing.
I don't want to get into like psychoanalyzing people right now, but what's going on?
I don't know. I think we're just losing our minds.
Why can't they just hang out?
Right.
Like how exhausting to like every time something happens, they have to like come up with a theory. They have to reverse engineer, right? Because they're like, the government's sending out an emergency
signal. They're like, we're going to make a noise on your phone on October 4th. And they're like, oh my God.
We have to figure out why this is...
They're going to turn us into zombies.
Like, what is... They don't want us to be zombies.
Did every time when you were a kid when this happened on TV, did you, like, run to the closet
well,
and cover your ears?
We didn't have 5G, so...
So it wasn't activating anything.
So we have the vaccine. But didn't the thing you were watching say even if you didn't get the vaccine, you will be activated?
No matter your vaccine status,
so
you will still be activated.
Who cares if you got the vaccine?
It's because they're trying to sow fear.
The radio frequencies trigger the neuro nanoparticles in the skin tissue.
Yeah.
To
zombify you.
I hate it. I mean, it's fun. It would be funny if it wasn't also like scary. I loved all of this until the gold people. And I'm like, oh, there's repercussions for this.
Like people are terrifying.
Yeah, like people are fucking scary and they're not having fun with these ideas.
They are
We're
not.
Having fun.
Like this is, again, conspiracy theories can be fun. What if the world was flat and there was an outside rim that we didn't know about?
Right.
How crazy would that be? But that's where the idea ends because it's not real.
It's not real. It's fun intellectual exercise.
Sure.
I don't know. I'm getting very baffled.
But you have to know when to cut that off.
You got to stop and just hang out, dude.
Just hang
out. Like, relax. Even if it's all true, just hang out until it happens.
Like, mark my words. October 4th will come.
It will.
And no one will be harmed from a sound that can play from their phone.
That's no different than getting like a text or any
right
signal to the phone.
It's not like we're all going to be like,
you know, like the John Cusack. That's literally like how they picture this happening.
That is
everyone what, just like
they, and that's what they want. They which want is like that.
So deranged.
It's crazy.
Well, isn't today the 20th? Isn't today supposed to be the end? Also,
yeah. Today is. We're recording this on the 23rd, and so far the world has not ended.
Maybe so. When the clock strikes midnight tomorrow.
Right. Then it'll all be over.
But even that, they don't explain how we're all going to die. What's the point of the Great Reset? I have to look into this.
We'll do more research. We'll come back to you and let you know what's going on with the Great Reset. But yeah, I don't know. But these are all the same people.
I live in fear now. I knew they were out there, but now I'm directly affected and I...
Well, it was sort of ambiguous.
Right.
It was a mist. Like, we separated. Knew they're there, but it's sort of like you know tigers are out there.
Sure.
But it's different when you see one and it's running at you.
Yeah.
I wish there was a way to know that people thought there was an... Like, who thinks there's an ice wall? Yeah. Who thinks that on October 4th... If there was a way to know that about people... You could make a better decision about who to talk to.
And just how to talk to them.
And how to talk to them.
They could just wear badges.
Because those people, you just want to be like, yes, okay.
I agree.
Goodbye. I like you. We're friends. It's like, so there was this gathering of like 1,000 people in Berlin who identify as dogs.
Like identify as dogs?
Like they think, they believe that they are dogs.
But are they, like, how committed are they? Is it like that guy that, like, turned himself into a border collie?
I think this was roughly inspired by that, yeah.
Is this, like, a knockoff, like, low commitment?
Well, there's, let me send you this link here.
Okay.
Of...
Oh, I'm just moving my legs.
Okay, yeah, so there's, do you see the link I just sent?
Yes, I do.
So this is a video on Twitter of... People who believe they're dogs. They're gathering at Potsdamer Platz Railroad Station in Berlin. And this was all organized for a group called Canine Beings, which advocates for the rights of people who identify as dogs. I don't know what special rights they need, but go ahead and hit play
maybe
here.
To pee wherever they want. Very low commitment. I was hoping for like the border collie guy where they look like dogs.
These are just people in like t-shirts with a dog mask on.
Assholes. And then the poor dogs of Berlin are just like, because there's like,
well, they're just howling.
Yeah.
Like dogs don't do that.
I guess huskies, but
maybe
if there's a fire truck.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. If a fire truck drives by, maybe, but I've been around dogs my entire life. Literally not once ever. Have they just sat around howling at each other?
Yeah. I think just huskies because they're like wolves.
Right. So if you identify as wolves, you can sit there and howl like that. But dogs don't howl.
They're just...
For no reason.
They're identifying as dogs whose owners have left for work. Because Alex's dog kind of howls when he's upset.
That's true.
Our friend Alex.
Our friend Alex, we watch his dog sometimes. And when we leave, we'll hear... Arr! Just when, yeah, but he's sad.
So it's a howl of sorts.
But they're not just our other dogs don't join in the howling. Dogs don't just sit there as a group howling.
Just wolves. So they're like, they identify with a certain kind of
dog scenario. In a very specific situation. Yeah.
Like not a happy dog. I associate myself with a sad dog, a forlorn dog.
Yeah, I mean, these people have come under lots of criticism.
They could have just barked. Dogs bark.
Yeah, sure.
More fun, honestly.
Than howling, yeah.
I mean, I guess howling is they do it to build bonding and stuff, so maybe it's just a bonding exercise.
I don't know, but people are criticizing them. They've been mocked widely over the internet.
Is it the similar gold people where it's like, this is the slippery slope of identifying as whatever gender you, now they're animals and they're bestiality.
I don't know. I think that I am all for this. Getting out, like, if you identify as a dog, please get out in public and howl.
Hell yeah.
So that I know how to talk to you.
Sure.
Because it used to be you'd be at work and it'd be like, why is Tom? Tom's kind of a weird guy, huh?
Yeah.
What's wrong with Tom? And no one knew what was wrong with Tom.
Now we know he's a dog because.
But now it's like, oh, Tom's weird because Tom's a dog when he goes home.
And they're not disguised, so it's very easy to spot Tom if you know Tom. Because they're not, I don't mind, honestly. I'm just not impressed with the low commitment. If you're going to be a dog.
Commit.
Put on some
Have fur surgically attached to your
shave
body.
Shave your dog.
And then you can be a dog.
Super glue it.
It kind of reminds me of like, so years ago I lived in this neighborhood where there was this house full of these insane women who at night would just scream at each other.
Like domestic violence?
Well, I would just wake up and I'd be like, ah!
It seems bad.
But it turned out it was just cats. It wasn't women at all.
Oh.
So it wasn't
so
human women.
So you just
women.
Thought these women are suffering and you're like, duh.
Yeah, I was like, God, these women Shut are up. Screaming again. But it was just cats, so.
They can sound quite horrifying.
It's terrifying yeah. that cats do that. But, yeah, so it kind of reminds me of that. But as a side note, for that reason, I do not support humans identifying as cats. And for that reason only.
Yeah.
Because if cats sound like humans when they're screaming like that at night, then yeah. I don't need it to actually be humans.
Right. Yeah.
So.
Okay.
So don't do that.
Are people just making fun of them or are they, is there like animosity towards these people?
I think they're just making fun of them.
Okay.
Like, this is stupid.
I wonder how international, like, you know what I mean?
Well, let's be very clear here that these people are not furries.
Yes.
And furries are a different thing from these people, so.
I like these ones more.
Than the furries?
Yeah, I don't know how to talk to a furry. I can talk to someone who likes to howl.
Like, sit, go. Yeah.
Lay down.
Bad dog, no. No howl. Don't howl.
No howl. Yeah, see, flaunt genders, orientations, yeah. Call animal control and give them their rabies doses.
What I'm over is people thinking they're special.
Yeah, no, you don't matter.
None of us matter. I don't matter. You don't matter. Nobody matters.
And I find that empowering.
We're all going to die, and no one will remember that we ever existed in 20 years after we die. Especially. And that's a stretch.
Yeah.
Like Johnny Carson died. When was the last time you thought about him until I just said his name?
When did he die?
Like in the 90s.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, I think about him sometimes because all the late night hosts have to talk about him.
True.
Like, because Johnny Carson, they probably don't even like him. They just have to say it because.
I'll never be Johnny.
Yeah, he set their career in place. Johnny Carson.
But yeah.
I wonder if he was up to no good. Yeah.
Every guy on TV.
Up to no good.
Up to no good.
And I don't want to know.
Steve Harvey?
Love him.
Love him. And I don't want to know, but he did some bad stuff.
I don't know how Bill Maher has gone unscathed. There's no way, and I like him, but there's no way he hasn't, like, done something.
Oh, he's done stuff.
But he's getting away with it.
I don't think he's getting away with it. I think that he's always been a sleazy slime man. And so you can't, like, yeah. out him for being a sleazy slime man.
Oh, no, you're... Yeah, it's like, well, yeah.
Like Ashton Kutcher killed his ex-girlfriend.
What?
Yeah, he like, you haven't heard this?
Murdered?
So Ashton Kutcher alleges that he, back in, I guess, the early 2000s.
Is this real? Continue.
Yes, this is real. He alleges that he went to his girlfriend's house, knocked on the door, looked in the window, saw wine all over the place, red wine.
Blood? Or
And he thought, I'm just going to leave. She's drunk and passed out. And he left. That's his story. But The police found his girlfriend or ex-girlfriend murdered.
Do they have like crime scene photos?
Murdered. I don't know. But yeah, so people think that Ashton Kutcher may have killed his girlfriend.
So he just like peered in and was like, huh, she spilled red wine everywhere. Gonna go.
So he allegedly called his...
So the Hollywood Ripper got the death sentence for the murder of his girlfriend?
I guess so, yeah.
So has he been framed?
Maybe Ashton Kutcher is the Hollywood Ripper.
He has to be... He had to kill multiple Hollywood people. Otherwise, it doesn't... You don't get that nickname. Crimes... Like, even Ashton Kutcher's girlfriend is not... Yikes. Yeah, he stabbed her 47 times.
Probably not Ashton. He probably walked in, saw her dead, but was like, people are going to think I did that because she's my ex-girlfriend and I'm here. Why would it not be me? So he...
I would probably leave because it's in... Well, I guess it's immoral if she was still alive. You know, because
I don't know. I mean, it is immoral, but also like they're going to think it's Ashton.
Yeah.
Even as proved by the fact that today people think it's Ashton.
Yeah. I would leave.
I would leave.
I would leave.
If I walked in and saw you stabbed 47 times, I would cry. And then I would say, oh no, people think that I did this. Oh dear,
because it's always the man.
It's always the ex.
Huh. Yeah, I didn't know that.
I wouldn't leave you. If you were still alive, I wouldn't leave you.
Well, it sounds like he didn't even know if she was alive. She could have been alive.
Right. But he's like, I'm just going to get in it. Apparently, he called one of the his friends from that 70s show and like a producer or his agent, maybe. And they were just like, you got to leave.
Did anyone watch that 70s show?
You saw wine and you left.
It was wine.
And it was wine.
It bled like wine.
So.
Did anyone watch the 70s show?
I mean, back then, yeah.
Was it popular?
It was very popular.
I don't think I know a single person that's ever watched it. I don't ask.
I've never watched it.
I don't.
But people did.
It was really popular.
It was like Scrubs. It was very popular. But I never watched it.
I hate Scrubs.
Scrubs is a not funny show.
It sucks. I hate Scrubs.
Well, did you hear that Elon Musk?
What?
He's starting human trials with Neuralink to put an implant into a brain by a robot, which he's already killed monkeys doing this.
What?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
He has killed monkeys.
I'm sad now.
It wasn't on purpose.
What do they do? What is the mental? I don't mean to just shit on the side, but what is the gymnastics? Because he's their guy. He's the free speech titan. What is the gymnastics when their guy is literally, not subtly, just quite deliberately implanting...
To read like, all your thoughts.
Like Bill Gates is putting the vaccine, this nano, like Elon's just straight up putting it in your brain.
Yeah.
And they're just like...
And he's like, that's what I want to do.
What is he doing? What's
so get next? This. When they So it's being implanted into the brain...
Is it actually having a human
by
shot?
A robot.
Okay.
Into a human brain. Through volunteers. By a robot.
Are we in human trials? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're moving into human trials with Neuralink. And so a robot's going to open up skulls of people and implant a chip into their brain, close up the skull, staple it shut. And then guess what this chip is going to be able to do?
Read your thoughts and emotions and inner desires and dreams.
Control a computer cursor and keyboard.
So it takes out the work of using a computer.
And I get that it's like the beginning stages, but
are you fucking serious?
That is all that they're hoping to achieve.
You lazy assholes.
Is to control, like this sounds like 1998.
It sounds like, and that sounds like a conspiracy, but it's true. It's happening.
No one wants, like, I've never been using my computer and been like, God damn it, if I just didn't have to use these hands.
I mean, that's what Apple does with their $17,000 headset, right?
It's yes.
Like, and even that, people are like,
I don't need it, but okay.
Like, who's going to... I can't believe that they are okay with this. That's the problem when you tie yourself to someone ideologically, is like, well, we can't separate from him now.
Right. We're so all like, in.
So yes to the Neuralink, no to the high frequency...
Right.
Emission from the phone that I will control with my brain from the chip in my brain.
Like,
is there more use case that he says this is for?
Ultimately, the goal is to be able to read your thoughts and like record your memories and all of that.
Is it like Black Mirror where they're like just like hardcore journaling?
Hardcore journaling?
Like, why would you want this?
That's a great question.
The only thing that makes sense is if it's like Black Oreo. Neon Oreo, the TV show, where it's they recorded everything and then they got into trouble somehow. I don't know. It caused drama. But they recorded every part of their life and then they can revisit and it's like you were there a lot, you know.
Sure.
We could revisit this and be like, oh, remember when we were in our 30s?
Or we could just record it.
Which we're doing now because I don't need every moment of my life recorded.
They tried to get a monkey to play Pong and it died. They hooked all this shit into its brain and then it was just like ting, ting, gone.
Really?
Yeah.
It's so cruel. They're us.
Like, who the hell would sign up for this?
Like, we're not okay with them killing people, like, but they're us.
It just was playing Pong and died, and now what you happened? you want the robot to put that thing in you? That's crazy.
This is real. I believe you, but...
Well, I mean, like you said, people are just... I was on board with Elon until Twitter, and I think we've talked about this, but so many people are just... You'll see so many Teslas on the road.
Yeah.
So many Teslas. And first of all, they're ugly cars.
They are ugly.
Like, there are some cars that are just timeless. Like a 1980 BMW M1 looks so good.
I don't know what that is, and but it feels good.
A Jeep? Looks like it's always been.
It's always existed.
And it still looks like that. Like
Tesla's already dated.
A Corvette from the 90s. Trucks from the 90s. Like, there are plenty of cars that look timeless. A Tesla is not one of those.
It looks like it's trying to be the future.
Like, there are cars that looked cool when they came out. Like a PT Cruiser.
Which is incredible.
But then you look at that now and it's just like, oh my God.
I feel so bad for anyone that interacted with one.
If you see someone driving a PT Cruiser, it's like,
but I've never seen one. What happened? People did they just, recall them?
No, I think did people just were like, so embarrassed that they just took them. Like, they worked fine. Everything was great, but they just drove them right to the junkyard and walked 4 miles back
and
home.
They just paid off the loan, like, took the hit.
Like, I just can't like be seen in that.
VW Beetles, and those are seen as like, you know, 2000. And I see those still. Fine.
Sure.
I've never seen a PT Cruiser since like 2005.
Embarrassment got them all gone.
Wow. How do we apply that to other things?
But yeah, I mean, yeah, you're going to see in 5 to 10 years, you're going to see a Tesla and be like, oof, that looks like 2018.
Well, and also like, what are you going to do during the apocalypse without the chargers? You can't have these people that are all pro-electric. And it's like, you can't drive your fucking car if it can't be charged.
I wonder how much... There can't be a lot of crossover there between, like, the gold apocalyptic people and the Elon fans.
I think there's crossover.
Maybe there is. I don't know.
I think that is his base. But then you have liberals that care. I don't know. It's all a hot mess. Honestly, I'm not on board with electric cars. I'm not, you know, educated enough on this, but they're not good for the environment.
They're not good for anything.
My estimation.
These massive fucking batteries.
Yeah.
They just, there's a video of a Tesla that crashed into a truck on the highway and just literally immediately exploded. Because the battery is just,
yeah.
Yikes. It's a bomb.
Not good.
But yeah, in 5, 10 years, you're going to look at your Tesla. It's like those modern apartment buildings. Like, do a Google search for just modern apartment. Yeah, if you do a Google search for modern apartment building. Yeah. And they all have, like, there's...
Like these? Or like...
Yeah, with the orange... Scroll down a little bit. They always have the orange section. Yeah, that one. Yeah. That's got the orange section. That's how you know it's a modern apartment building if it has the orange section.
Is it like an accent? Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, they do that. That's how you know it's modern.
What the hell is it?
Got to have the orange block, I guess. I don't know.
You can make them in.
But like already, that looks like 2016. Like that looks like 2016.
Oh, and that's here.
Oh.
Well, let's see if we can live there. I don't want
to
look
at it. I hate when you click on something and it takes you
to where the picture
was. The idea.
Yeah, like I'm not going to go through the map to find this goddamn.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah, modern, you just got to stick with the old.
Just make a building look like a building. If you Google, you don't have to, but just.
I will.
Google searching like New York apartment building. That's what they should all look like.
Like the bricks, the brickstone. What do they call it?
The brownstone.
Brownstone.
Like that's what every building should look like.
Yeah.
It's fine. It doesn't need to be crazy. It's just if you're designing something and you're like, does this look like now? Because if it looks like now, now is going to leave.
Tomorrow. It's already over.
It should look like always.
Yes.
That should be the question that they ask. Does this car look like always? Because if the answer is no, you've just dated your fucking Tesla, Elon Musk. You make ugly bullshit. And you name things ugly shit, like X.
Because you just add X's to everything like a child.
He is.
He's a big man, baby. And what? Were we looking at his, because he had another kid, right?
I don't even know.
Elon Musk baby names. The one that no one knows is old news. I never learned how to say it. But apparently it's X-A12. The X is just X and the A12 is just A12, he said to Joe Rogan. Then Grimes tweeted X, the... Oh, sorry, that X was really heavy. The
That's
X,
okay.
The unknown variable X, A-E, my elven spelling of AI...
Which my is, elven spelling of
my
AI?
My elven... This is Grimes, by the way, but they're one unit. Oh, are they broken?
Yeah, they're done. They separated.
He's the most, like, asexual being.
Can you imagine Elon Musk having sex?
I can't imagine. There's uglier people, but
sure.
He would be the worst to be. God.
Can you? What does he do to Grimes?
And he has so much money that he can do anything. You know what I mean?
He doesn't know what's normal.
I'm like kind of
for anything.
Out. I'm like in a dark place right now, picturing that. I don't want that in my
like
mind.
Like the lights are dim. Elon Musk takes his shirt off.
It's less the movements and the sound, the grunts.
It's the grunts. It's Elon's grunts that get you.
Can you imagine? Oh my God, that pale beluga whale.
Imagining Elon Musk having sex is terrifying. You want your idol to be like a fuck god.
Yes.
You know?
You want him to be like anyone, but...
You don't want him to be like...
That's a thousand.
And also, he doesn't make a facial expression.
Yes, that's the problem.
That's Elon Musk having sex.
Those are the sounds I was picturing in my mind. Whew. We don't have to keep talking. I'll just finish up. A-12, precursor to SR-17, our favorite aircraft. No weapons, no defenses, just speed. Great in battle, nonviolent. Plus A equals Archangel.
Archangel.
My favorite song. Then his most recent child is easy to pronounce. But it's Technomechanicus, which just sounds like a transformer.
It's like he was 8 years old when he made his kid's name. He made a list of what his kid's names would be at 8 years old.
And 14.
And he never budged. He never grew up out of that.
He was like, these are the names. Like, that kid's going to get so shat on for multiple reasons. Technomechanicus? I also just feel like you can't be white with that name.
Hi, I'm Technomechanicus. Like, you're what? I'm going to beat the fuck out of you.
Because there's no shorthand for tech or mech. Poor
could
child.
Be Mac. Mechanicus. It's a stretch, but that's what I would choose. I'm Mac. My legal name is Technomechanicus.
They have nicknamed the child Tau. So.
All right.
That's the latest on Elon Musk having sexual intercourse in the name of his children. 11 children. He doesn't have 11 part. Well, maybe he has had 11 children. He's impregnated women 11 times.
And he just throws them in the garbage as soon as he has them.
And he misses every time. God, now he's, I can't take it.
Well, I do.
I'm sorry for those sighs. Sometimes it's just really how I feel.
Well, hopefully this will help you. We're going to move on to some lighter news.
Really?
All right. That was just transition music.
I loved
music.
That song.
Apparently, they've changed the name of the Weinermobile, the Oscar Mayer Weinermobile.
Are they embarrassed of the word wiener?
Well, over the summer, they changed it to the Frankmobile. And I'm guessing because they were trying to avoid the obvious connotations of a Weinermobile.
I feel like they should have done that in like 2007.
So they changed it to the Frankmobile in May of this year, but they've missed the old name.
They reverted?
So they've changed it back to the Weinermobile.
Because it wasn't getting enough attention or, you know, because Frankmobile is boring.
Frankmobile,
so
yeah.
So like, we're not getting enough attention.
Weinermobiles, it's a little provocative, but you know what it really means.
Yeah. How many are, is there one or is there like multiple? And
that's a great, I don't know, but this
is
thing.
Is there like an ice cream truck, but it has wieners?
I don't know. So growing up, seeing the Weinermobile was like seeing Nessie. Like what? The Loch Ness Monster.
Oh.
That's name is Nessie.
His nickname is Nessie.
Like my dad, growing up, my dad told me a story like, son, one time I saw the Weinermobile. And I was amazed. Like my dad saw the Weinermobile.
It's like my dad seeing the Beatles. It's like, what?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Then one day I saw it.
You've seen it.
I've seen
it. With your eyes.
And it was glorious. Truly majestic. It's just, it's one of those memories that will never go away. It was the light of my time being alive.
Is there one?
I think there's one.
It's just like going around. Like,
look up. So in the notes, I've got a link.
You've seen it?
I've seen it in person, yeah. So this is the Oscar. Like, click on, let's see, that third picture from the top.
This one?
Yeah, that one. Like, look at that thing. That's incredible. It's amazing. Like, what
is inside, though?
What happens inside of the Weinermobile?
It's just like one of those Airstream, like.
It's like a fucking, it's like a sex dungeon.
You can stay overnight in it.
Oh, my God. This is amazing. Like, look at that. Like, they had that thing custom made.
Yeah. How much do you think it costs?
$3,500 a night.
$136? For one night only? You motherfuckers. So three people got to review it. Bill, Stephanie, and Benjamin.
I would love to stay in the Weinermobile.
Well, I hate them. They're the only ones. And the bill is like once in a lifetime opportunity. We will be delighted for years to come that we got to have dinner with our friends at the Weinermobile and spend the night. What an impassionate.
Very impassionate.
Unpassionate.
Depassioned.
Unpassionate. Depassionate. We'll be delighted for years. Like, how about delighted for a lifetime, motherfucker?
Yeah. Like this is going to fade away. Like, I still look back at my memory of seeing. I look back at my dad telling me he saw the Weinermobile with such fondness.
Yeah,
it brings me joy to even remember hearing that.
That wasn't even like seeing. That was just hearing someone.
I had like a little toy hotmobile of the Weinermobile.
Yeah.
And the fact that you think that this will fade off in years. Go fuck yourself.
Suck a dick, Bill.
Yeah.
This was 4 years ago. What's going on? Okay, so they have renamed it.
So, yeah, it was the Frankmobile. Now they've changed it back, so we have the Weinermobile again.
How many Weinermobiles are there?
Great question.
Six.
Okay. I thought there was like two.
The driver is called the Hot Dogger. His job is to meet and greet people around the country. Well, how do I tour schedule be a hot dogger? Can I apply to be a hot dogger?
I wouldn't want the responsibility of driving that thing around. If you ding the Weinermobile,
there's one in Las Vegas.
So much guilt.
I can't wait to see it.
You've never seen it?
No.
It's
I didn't
amazing.
Know it was real, if I'm honest. I just thought it was like a little car. like a toy.
No, it's a real thing. And seeing it is a sight to behold. I just hope that that thing never goes away.
It's really cute.
People shouldn't be eating hot dogs, but I hope that enough people kill themselves with that stuff.
Yeah, to fund.
To fund Oscar Mayer keeping the Weinermobile alive.
It's really quite endearing. Oscar Mayer? Mayer?
It's Mayer. That's a Mandela effect, though.
No way.
Yeah.
That's an A?
People, yeah.
But it's Oscar Mayer?
I don't know. That's a Mandela effect.
If I was on a game show...
You'd lose.
If I was on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire for $500,000, and it was like, what is the who makes the Weinermobile? I would bet $500,000 that it was Oscar Mayer.
I think they'd give it to you.
No, if it's multiple choice.
Oh, if they... Okay, so yeah. You'd... Okay.
I'd be like, oh, the Oscar Mayer's in there to fuck with you. No.
Well, I think it's about time to wrap up. But before we do, we have two things we have to address.
Yes.
One.
Sorry, I didn't fart.
Is guess what we saw. If you can guess what we saw, you'll win $500. And if you don't guess what we saw, you can't win because that's not how games work.
You owe us $500. For everyone who doesn't guess, owes us $500.
It's true.
I love the song.
No one guessed this week.
Not even the one that got the gift card.
No,
I guess because
one...
we said he wouldn't get another card.
So he didn't guess again.
You can guess again. We'll give you a card.
Let me just be sure that this is true. I don't think that we've had any other guessers, but I just want to make sure.
I'm going to start guessing.
Yeah. It says we can't win in the rules.
But we can guess.
Let's see. Yeah, we've had no new
calls,
guesses,
right?
It would appear that no one cares about anything we do.
It's kind of liberating in a way, though.
It is, yeah.
Because, you know.
Yeah, so we should apologize to the gold people.
Non-sarcastically.
Truly authentically.
Because I am so scared of them.
So
this is like a Stockholm Syndrome apology.
Yes, 100%.
Let me get good posture because I feel like they would criticize posture.
That's pretty good.
And I'm going to look at the camera. Shoulders
back.
Back?
Yes, there we
like
go.
Like that?
That's how a good posture be.
Are you serious?
That's what I'm doing.
I don't look ridiculous.
It feels bad.
It feels like so...
unnatural.
Yeah.
But it looks normal.
Okay, they don't like a sloucher. Okay.
Like well. Like Ronnie DeSanti.
Yeah.
Ronnie DeSanti, you're a slouchy boy. And what are you chewing on? Okay.
Okay, I'm going to look at the camera. I never look at the camera. But if I'm going to be heartfelt, I'm going to look into that goddamn camera.
All right. It's time to apologize to the Goldies. What are they called?
Goldbugs. But we don't call them it. I'm sure those are triggering names because they're demeaning. I'm going to move my microphone like this.
This is to you, wise people who have invested in gold.
And own gold coins for the apocalypse or societal
destabilization.
Stabilization.
When society becomes destabilized single-handedly by Joe Biden, we have learned and recognize that gold is the only thing that can protect you.
Yes. At first, we thought we were mocking the
idea.
Look
at them. Look at them in the eyes.
So at first, we were mocking you. But then we were ignorant, and they told us, and we learned, and we're admitting our mistakes, that we were wrong.
Gold is so important.
Gold is important. Gold coins are important. And when the power grid collapses... What?
And they fails. Said
you can build it back quickly, right?
Yeah.
And gold can be measured.
Through mercury.
Through mercury. And we love gold.
We love gold.
And we hope to God we never have to use it, but I'm going to get some gold. Are you going to get some gold?
We're going to stock up on gold.
We're going to stock up on gold.
Golden guns. The
best investment you can
get.
Not
gold and guns. No, golden guns.
Yeah, that's if you really want to be prepared for the Lohopolis, then you'll have a golden gun.
So we are sorry for making fun of you.
We were wrong.
And we'll always be wrong.
And we'll always feel bad about it. We are repentant. We are ignorant pieces of shit.
If there's three things we love, they all start with G, and that's gold, God and guns. Gold is what we live for
and die for.
Gold is what we live for. Gold is what we die for. Gold is what we aim for. And gold is what we why.
Amen.
So, yeah.
Do you think they'll... I feel like that's pretty... I don't think there was sarcasm.
None.
What about the guy that told you that our combined IQ is less than your hair dye?
Somebody thinks that I dye my hair?
And beard.
And beard? I have grays in my...
grays. I don't know what we need to do to convince people you don't dye your beard.
People think that I dye my hair and beard, especially the beard.
Insane.
But to someone who thinks that I dye both my hair and my beard, that would indicate that... So if I'm dyeing both my hair and my beard, then that means that either my hair color is my beard color, or my beard color is my hair color. And then I'm dyeing them both. What is that? Why would I do that? I would only dye one or the other.
Yes. To match.
To match, yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't dye to mismatch.
Right.
And confuse.
That would be crazy.
That would be crazy.
To dye my beard or hair a color other than what matches would be an insane thing to do.
Yeah. So to him, but, you know, he was right. Gold is good.
Our IQ is
stupid.
Is low.
Our IQ is lower than
13. It's a miracle that we were even able to be taught the lesson that gold has value.
It's incredible that we even figured out how to turn on these microphones, which contain immense amounts of gold. Gold has lots of functions, and it can be used for everything, and it will save us.
Yes. When we're all dying on our deathbeds, we'll wish that we had gold.
Really so. Grinds my...
We never argued that gold doesn't have value. Now,
yeah, they were like, gold can be used as a conductor. Like,
okay.
We're just saying if you're in The Last of Us...
Are you making microphones when October 4th and the tone goes off and everyone turns into zombies? You're going to be making gold conductors for your microphones?
Also, please. They feel like very witty when they're like, that room is more gold than it's been. Like slam, like... We're not saying gold isn't in anything. Or just say we don't want to spend $2,000 for an 1 ounce coin. It's not a good investment. I'd rather spend $2,000 on literally anything else.
Anything.
Anything.
So, but not anymore, because now we are Goldbergs.
Bugs. I don't think they want to be called that. What do they want to be called? Gold vigilantes.
The golden gods.
The golden... But is that sacrilegious? Because...
There's no winning. We can't win. We are
gold aficionados.
But anyway, I think that wraps up the podcast.
Guess what we saw.
Give us a call.
Call us. Call us and tell us why you won't guess what we saw.
Please. All right.